looking for the King of Podcasts? You're in the wrong channel. Looking for good ideas for life? You are far from good hands. If you think the listener is always right, you are far from the right place. Hosted by a Northeasterner by birth, a rebel by choice. If you want a host that floats between love and madness, then play on and listen to Crazy Train Radio.
What up, Crazy Train Radio?
You want answers?
I think I'm entitled.
You want answers?
I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth!
I love scotch. I love scotch. Scotchy, scotch, scotch. Here it goes down, down into my belly.
Don't mess with me, I'm one crazy mofo.
Hey folks, it's your least favorite host in the podcast world, Croc, Jonathan Steele.
And I'm Elena, your favorite host from the Emerald Isles.
And boy, do we have a good one for you today.
So folks, I wanted to take a few minutes to kind of do a formal introduction, because I know you now hear her in the intro, but also have heard her in a couple of the previous conversations, and you will be hearing her in future conversations, pending schedule and all that stuff, because she, this person on the line now, is currently from some place called Galway, Ireland. Miss Elena Tully. Elena, how are you doing and what's going on at the moment?
Hi, Jonathan. I'm doing good. So greetings from Galway, everybody. And it's lashing rain outside as usual. And I'm looking forward to this.
I know she's been sweating this, so this next little conversation will be brought to you by degree. All kidding aside, though, wanted to do this as kind of a short introduction, so people are familiar with Elena, because unfortunately folks have heard my voice since 2012. So first and foremost, I guess, Elena, and it's a kind of an open-ended question, but I'll let you take it in the direction you are comfortable with. What is your background? I know people have heard you say about acting and stuff in a few conversations, such as with Lynn Shay and all, but what is your background, and just what are you willing to put out there currently?
Basically, what you hinted on before, acting is my life's ambition and dream, and that basically would sum up me as a person. I'm very passionate about it, and I do have that temperament that I reach for my goals and my dreams, and I'm very dedicated and determined to at least achieve some sort of aspect of that. And I've been actively trying to do that since I got out of college at 18, and I am nearly a big number this year, next year in March, and I'd like to say that I have achieved some sort of progress in the last while, so I'm happy with that. Otherwise, I guess just a very creative person in general. So if it's not acting, I do like to sing, and I do I write scripts, and if I can't act, I do try and do things in the background that are linked to that. I suppose, what else can I say, really? It's like, if anybody knows me here, they know I'm just bonkers about movies and would spend lots of times just quoting movies for no reason, and spending days just, yeah, talking about acting, actors, trying to do everything. And I'm thinking I've been involved in musical theater over here in societies, is what we call them. So I would be on stage dancing and singing if I couldn't do camera work, which I've had a few extra roles. We don't have a big, huge industry like they would in America, but from the work that I've got here, I've been a background actor or an extra, and sometimes I've had like speaking roles. So I think I'm on the right track, and I'm super, super excited to be involved with you on this show. And it's literally a dream come true, because I didn't think I'd actually get to explore this aspect of creating. So I'm very grateful to you, Jonathan, and I'm having an absolute blast, and I hope I can give the listeners a gist of what it's like in Ireland and an outlook of a different perspective. So
that's yeah, and two things with that is, first, as far as what you said in your answer there, it's nice to see, and I'm going to reference a recent conversation I had with Howard Berger, which is now out there. And it's nice, and when I reference that, it's nice to hear that you are trying to learn different avenues of the industry, whether it be writing, directing, other stuff behind the scenes. And most people definitely encourage folks to learn not just one aspect of it, such as what Howard did, not just makeup effects. It's, you know, you pick up different things. So it's nice to hear that you are trying to learn different crafts within your industry that you're trying to get into. But also, and I don't mean this in a negative standpoint, but it's good because it's, I guess, checks and balances. I will say, and without fully getting into it, that Elena is a cross between a, what we call here in the States, a worrywart, but also a mother hen. And when I say that, it's without getting too into the business side of things and all that, which most people are aware of. Elena is always asking about just different aspects to cover one's ass, I will say. And I'm not saying that in a bad way. She does it out of, I guess, what's the best word? What's the word I'm looking for? Love and admiration.
Exactly. I care. Yeah. I care a lot. If not, I care too much.
Yes. Like I said, it's all in what, so, because obviously me and Elena have had this conversation a few times, so we know where everybody stands. But if people are hearing this and go, wow, he brought her on and he's ripping her already. No, this ain't ripping her. She does everything is out of loving concern and wanting to see things succeed and continue on the track things have been going on. So it's actually a good thing. Like I said, it's more of a checks and balances kind of thing. And it shows that she's trying to learn because she is asking questions and, well, what about this? What about that? And it's a nice thing to have, especially when you've been doing, for the most part, things solo for 8 years. But the other thing I want to bring up before we wrap this part up, as far as the introduction, because a couple people asked, not many, because I think most within this close circle of the show are aware of Elena, especially since the summer because of watch-alongs and stuff. But some folks have asked, why Elena? And why did it make sense to bring her on board for when she's available schedule-wise for when we do things? And I don't think I've had this we may have had this conversation privately, but hold on 1 second.
Oh. You okay?
Sorry. Yeah, I'm okay. That's why I said, excuse me for a sec. But no, the question has come up from a couple of fans, but it's not that big of a deal. And I think I've answered this with Elena privately, but because she asked directly, because Elena is sweet with it. Because whenever she asks something, she goes, are you sure? Are you back to that mother hen thing there, which is all out of love. Everything's, it's all good. And it was funny. I'll tell you this too, because I mentioned it to when I was talking privately with Brooke Thies, which you will hear Elena on as well in our recent history. Well, it wasn't just Brooke, but Toy Newkirk was talking about it as well. And I know you've had a conversation with Toy as well recently that you shared with me. But as I've told people behind the scenes and such, it's always been, I wasn't per se looking for co-host and person with multiple hats, because Elena's trying to do some stuff, other stuff behind the scenes as far as producing, as far as guests and stuff like that. And it's not like was looking, at least from my end, for somebody. But it was what I was telling Brooke and a few other folks that were having a conversation with about it. I said it was just one of those things that felt right. And Elena would know this because we've had this conversation, that I am more of a, right or wrong, more of a gut instinct kind of thing person, I guess is the best way to put that. And most people that have some sort of creative outlet, when something works, but you also know when something doesn't work, and you just got to kind of go check that one off the box, move on. What's next? And Elena got involved with us, I guess it would have been, and correct me if I'm wrong, July-ish, when started getting involved with doing watch-alongs and stuff. And, of course, would have conversations with Elena, off the show and such, and or to watch-alongs. And invited her a couple times to join taped conversations, the interviews and such. And at least from my end, and I guess it would have been September-ish, maybe beginning of October at this point, because we're having this conversation November 23rd here in 2020. But there was just something, and it goes back to the gut instinct here, that felt right, that said, that when it, the topic of, hey, what about co-hosting and stuff came up, right away it just felt right, if that makes sense. Do I have my time period right about right there, Elena?
I think you do. Yes, it was definitely the watch parties. And I'm so, so thankful that you said that, because I have never felt so safe with someone so fast. And I trust you. And I am so honored that you felt that I contributed something to this. And I wasn't looking for this. I didn't actively go out and try and seek this from you. It was just a really happy surprise that happened, and it felt really nice to be included, and then it seemed to grow into something, and I'm very, very, very grateful for it. And anybody who knows me knows this is huge, absolutely huge to me, and I'm receiving a lot of encouragement from people who know me as a person and know that I'm not trying to, like, I didn't try to get this, if you know what I mean, like what you touched on there. I didn't actively go out and try to seek this for some kind of personal gain, in a way. Like, it just happened, and I'm absolutely over the moon with this opportunity. So thank you, Jonathan.
Yeah, like I said, it was just one of those things, and she agreed there. It was just one of those things that naturally over the time took its course, and just so far it's felt right. And I don't, you know, Elena, at least from a horror perspective of things, because we are sports and entertainment and all that kind of thing, she knows some of the same people that I know because of the show and gotten to know personally away from it, and deal with, such as a toy, a Brooke, you know, and a couple other people that don't need to be thrown under the bus here. but I will say them, because they've said it, and not that I'm getting into the full conversations. They were generally, when they heard that Elena was coming on board and that we were giving it a shot and everything felt right, these people were generally happy for her, which was awesome to hear that. And for some odd reason, I think at least one of them, when I saw the messages to Elena, I won't say who, I think they might need to be drug tested or checked for alcohol. But I won't say who it was that I sent the beer mug to. No, but all kidding aside, everybody seems to be thrilled with Elena being involved. Obviously, I've been happy with Elena so far. You know, she does. And I guess that's part of the thing I enjoy having her involved. What I've said a couple of times already, that mother hen aspect. That's one of the things I do enjoy, because what she will bring something up and go, she asks questions just to make sure everything is good. So I do appreciate that from her. So, but back to Elena there real quick before we wrap this up. Obviously, I know you use the Twitter machine and Instagram and stuff like that, but you know, actually two more things I want to bring this up, because I'm now that just hit me across the head too, as far as the extra roles and stuff. You know, that happens from time to time. Head not working. But hey, it is what it is, and kind of makes what we do what it is in certain aspects. But the extra roles you've done, and I know, were they all stateside? Because I know this might sound funny to some when I say this, but like, I know on one of the projects, she had her first trip to Walmart.
I did have my first trip to Walmart. No, not all my extra roles have been stateside. When I say extra roles, that's mainly what I can get over here in Ireland, in Galway, or in the various counties that we have. So that would be like a background actor. But I have to say that I have achieved an actual speaking role that I am so proud of in the past year. That's how I went over, and I went to Walmart. That was a movie called Crave Roots of Evil, and it was shot in Dallas, Texas. And I actually had a couple of lines, and I had a scene on screen, if not a few scenes, depending how it's edited together, with the actress Felissa Rose. So that has been my biggest achievement so far. And also, I did have a speaking line with Catherine Isabel in another movie called The Green Sea, which is in the stage for film festivals. So depending on COVID and everything, that should be circulating around soon. So I am absolutely over the moon to say that I have achieved a speaking role, never mind the fact that it's with these actors that I look up to. And as you know, I do love horror, so it's huge to me, and I'm absolutely grateful for everything that I am achieving. And yeah, so my trip to Walmart was was definitely an experience. It's something I'll always remember, and I hate to like say it, but I genuinely saw all the stuff that people do. You see these things in movies and you think people are joking, and then when you actually go there, it's exactly what you've been told. I saw a couple of people going around on those little bikes, or those little wheelchair things, their motorized bikes, and some were wearing their pajamas. it was an adventure.
I'm thinking of currently, as you say that, there is, and most of the listeners are familiar with Larry the Cable Guy. He right. has some bits about being entertained by watching some of the people. And yeah, just because he's got money and been successful and stuff, he does genuinely go to Walmart for stuff, toiletries, you know, food shop, you know, like everybody else. But I think in a bit he tells that some of the people that you see in stores like Walmart or Target, or, you know what I mean, some of these chain stores, especially the ones that are open very late, you do see a cast of characters.
Definitely. It was an adventure.
Yeah. You know, so, you know, like, it just made me think of that bit, because it's, you know, as even though it was set up for stand-up comedy, there's a lot of truth to that. And I'm glad someone, an outsider such as Elena, and I say that respectfully, brings that up, that hey, this shit you see on TV and movies and whatever, this shit's real. So
it's real.
Yeah, no, but the other thing I want to bring up, and I hope it's okay, if not we will, I know Elena will tell me in a nice way to go F myself, but I know, because, and I'm only asking because she has brought it up on several occasions personally, and I think it's kind of cool for folks to know, because I don't do it, but you meditate from time to time. Is there a particular style that you like meditate? And when I say style, there's, I guess it'd be more of the word philosophy, because there's different philosophies in terms of meditation and all that stuff. But is there two questions. Is there a particular philosophy you follow? But is there a particular reason why you started doing that?
That's a very good question, Jonathan. To be honest, I am big into meditation only in the last year or so. I overcame a lot in my life, and not to delve too much into that side of myself, but anybody who knows me, close friends, knows that I have had a bad few years, I suppose, dealing with certain things and overcoming that side of myself. I battled depression for a long time, and I still suffer with a bit of anxiety, as you've noticed, with my asking and overthinking and things like that. But I was recommended meditation by a friend, and more people started saying that to me. But that one particular friend that said it, it clicked in a way that it hadn't before, and I just started to do it. Like I was at a stage where I thought I could manage the depression, and I was seeing a lot of positive things. So it clicked at the right time, and I just kept doing it. But there is a particular person called Robert Sink on YouTube, and he pointed out that it's just basically about being grateful for everything. And once I had that outlook that I was so grateful to be out of that depression, because it honestly took a good few years out of my life because I could not see any way forward. And once I literally overcame the main thing that was bothering me, I just made it like a mantra, like every day, to keep that mindset and to keep that positive feeling. And when you think positive and do positive things and opportunities happen all around you. And I do believe in the law of attraction, and that is another side to meditation, of whatever you put out, you attract back, or you can, you know, whatever you want, literally put it to the universe, and the universe will give it to you. And it's all about blind faith and belief. But it's a nice way to think, because it's like your imagination and your childlike self. Like, we're only here once, we only have one life, so you might as well just do what the hell you want. And, you know, we're all going to die at some point, unfortunately. Yeah. But, you know, there's no point in living with regrets. And if you have an opportunity, you jump at it. You just do it, because it's, you don't know, tomorrow isn't promised. And that person who told me about meditation, I'm so grateful to her for the way that she said it, because it was like a kick up the ass. And it was like, right, you need to kind of look after yourself and work on yourself, and then meditation also will help. And I wasn't the kind of person who just, you know, meditated. Like, I didn't take it seriously. They'd be like, oh yeah, go meditate, and then you'd think it was just like, you know, 10 minutes and you're done. But I've made it into a way that it's literally every day. There are certain videos, like a gratitude meditation or certain music, or just to attract positive vibes. And you go into a trance-like state, and you feel better. You feel better in yourself. You know that there's, I don't know if everybody has different religions or beliefs, but I'm quite spiritual that way, that I do feel the energies, and I do feel I'm genuinely experiencing something out of it. And it makes me feel that the world is a lot more complex than what it is. And it just feels like I'm on the right track, kind of thing. It's kind of like a wake up call when you're not feeling great, or you know your body isn't great, and something is telling you, you know what, it's okay to not to feel okay, but this would help if you just take the time to look after yourself and have a meditation, or for as long as you want. There's different videos, everybody's different, but I highly recommend it. And especially if you're suffering with depression, or you're just having a down day, just you know, listen to yourself, listen to your body, listen to what everything is around you. Like, if you're outside, be with nature. Like, it's a thing. It's like I've had like an epiphany, I guess, just that side of myself. And I'm very, very grateful. I'm seeing things with a whole new perspective, because I was in that dark place for such a long time, and it's so refreshing and encouraging to myself to know that I can do things, and I am able to do certain, to do things, I guess, that I wasn't able to do before. And to have a kind of an outlook that, you know, I'm on the right path, kind of thing, that just because it's not happening now doesn't mean that it won't. Just to stay positive, and you see things in people as well. You know when people are not feeling okay, and I'm kind of like an empath that way too. I can feel things. So I think that's why I I like acting as well, because it's expressing things, and it's getting to delve into emotions, like, in a different way. It's playing different people that might not be like you, and it's a good way to channel out these things. So it's, yeah, meditation, I recommend it.
Well, part of that answer, and I do have to wrap here because of personal schedule, but part of that sounds like a book for those who were into that type of thing, meditation and such. A book called The Secret, I believe it's titled, that talks about some of that same philosophy. But the other thing is, too, that she brought up about her friend putting her foot up her ass. I just want it fully known, for Elena's sake, there's no health insurance, so I can't send you to a proctologist and help you with the copay.
Oh.
But look forward to having you involved with more stuff, and know this will be fun. This will be an interesting adventure with you, Elena. So cheers.
Cheers to you too, Jonathan, or Sláinte, as we say over here.
Yes, that works too.
Absolutely over the moon, and so grateful that you trust me on this journey, and I hope I can contribute in a positive way. And
she has. So.
Thank you, Jonathan.
Hi, this is Amanda Wist, and you're listening to Crazy Train Radio.